Det er en af de mest betydningsfulde surrealistiske malere fra dette århundrede, der nu er emnet for den film, vi sender. René Magritte, som her i Patrick McDonalds skikkelse fortæller om sit liv og sine inspirationer.
I remember when I was very young, just after we had moved from Lessons to Gilly, two balloonists arrived suddenly one day. Their balloon had become entangled on the roof. Dressed in leather and wearing goggles, they looked like men from another world. As I watched them, I was filled with a sense of mystery. In 1916, my father gave me permission to study at the Academie de Beaux-Arts in Brussels. I remember feeling resentful at the irreversible process of growing up. A melancholic pessimism descended upon me. Attempts to discover new ways of painting were laughed at by the public. Millar was accused of insulting peasants because he showed them as real human beings. Manet was described as chopping up women because he showed only the upper half of a girl behind a bar. I had developed a complete distrust of established art and artists. In my childhood, I used to play with a girl in an old abandoned cemetery at Soigny, where my grandmother lived. Together, we would enter the vaults and explore underground. Emerging into the light one day, I found among the broken stone columns and dead leaves a painter who seemed to be performing magic. Someone with the intention of playing a joke sent me a catalogue of a futurist exhibition. Thanks to that joke, I became familiar with a new kind of painting. Intoxicated, I produced a whole batch of futurist pictures. I was less concerned with technique than the futurists. One pure and powerful sentiment kept them from falling into their search for formal perfection. Eroticism. The little girl in the cemetery was the object of my daydreams, and she was bound up with the atmosphere of holidays and railway stations I had created for her. The pictures were interesting, but they somehow failed to convey the emotions I felt. What I had wanted to do was produce a shock. When I was a child, my mother occasionally slept in the same bed as myself, or with one of my brothers. One morning we awoke to find her missing. On the doorstep and pavement were footprints made in the early morning dew. These led away from the house. Recovered. Her face was veiled by the nightgown she'd been wearing. We were never sure if the water had done this, or if she'd covered her face to hide the death she had chosen. Her death forever remained a mystery. My brothers and I had an insatiable appetite for mystery, horror, and violence, which was catered for by the local cinema. Mummies wandering in their wrappings through deserted halls, haunted catacombs, and faceless enemies. These productions reached their climax with the Louis Fayard series Fantomas, who was my particular hero. Phantom is often seen as a soberly dressed man of average height and appearance, his favorite disguise.
Georgette?
We had not met since we were children at the annual fair, and boys and girls were kept strictly apart. As a joke, I told her I had a mistress. She understood my implication, and we were together from then on. She made some remark about the weather. I was anxious to tell her about my work. Futurism had freed me from the standstill I'd reached, but it failed to solve the main problems facing me. I was gradually becoming aware of a new way of looking at the world, in spite of the complicated detail and shading in the real landscape. I was able to see it as no more than a curtain hung in front of me.